This is part 11 of Azure tutorial. In our previous video, we discussed what is a virtual machine skill set and why we need it. In this video, we'll discuss how to create a virtual machine skill set. As usual, in the Azure portal, search for virtual machine skill set, or we can also search by its acronym VMSS, which obviously stands for virtual machine skill set. On this virtual machine skill set page, click Add. First, subscription, and then resource group. Let's actually create a new resource group. I'm going to name it RG-testing. A resource group, as you know, is a group of related Azure resources. This grouping allows us to manage all the resources that belong to a specific application and deployment environment as one unit. We can even automate deployments using Azure Resource Manager templates. We discussed resource groups in detail in part 5 of this video series. Next, a name for our virtual machine skill set. The common convention is to use the prefix VMSS, which obviously stands for virtual machine skill set, and we're going to use this skill set for a demo purpose. So let's name it VMSS-demo. Next, a region where we want our skill set to be created. At the moment, as you can see, South India region is selected. And if we scroll a bit down, notice availability zones are not available in this selected region. And if you're building a high availability system, then you may want to select a region where availability zones are supported. I know East US region supports availability zones, so let's select that. Notice, as soon as East US region is selected, availability zone is lightened up. And in this specific region, we have 3 availability zones. So let's check all these checkboxes. So our VMs in the skill set are distributed across these 3 availability zones. Next, image, that is the base operating system that you want on all your virtual machines in the skill set. As you can see from the drop-down list here, we have several choices, Windows or Linux. I'm going to use Windows 10 Pro version. Azure Spot Instance. This option is great for cost saving. Basically, it allows us to use unused Azure capacity at a significantly low price. However, at any point in time when Azure needs the capacity back, the Spot VMs are evicted with just 30 seconds notice. Therefore, Spot VMs are great for workloads that can handle interruptions like batch processing jobs, development or test environments, large compute workloads, etc. Next, we need to select the size of a VM. Basically, it is the size that determines the processing power, storage capacity, and memory. So, based on the size that we select and the operating system we have chosen, an hourly price is charged. I'm going to leave it at the default that we have right here. Next, an administrator username and password. Basically, we'll be using these credentials to log into our virtual machines in the skill set. It's very important we remember these credentials because in just a bit, we'll be using them to RDP, that is remote desktop protocol, into virtual machine in our skill set. Finally, check this licensing checkbox and then click next to configure the disks for our virtual machine skill set. I'm going to leave the defaults that we have here and then click next to configure networking options. We configure 3 things here: virtual network, network interface, and load balancing. Virtual network, or VNet as it is commonly called, allows virtual machines in our skill set to securely communicate with each other, the internet, and on-premises networks. It's very similar to a traditional network that you see in your own on-premise data center. Next, network interface. Just like a physical machine that you have at your home, a virtual machine can also have one or more network interface. It is this network interface that enables a virtual machine to communicate with other virtual machines, internet, and even on-premises servers. By default, the virtual machines we create in Azure are not accessible over the internet for obvious security reasons. However, you can override this by opening an inbound port. For example, let's say we want to access the VM over the internet using RDP, that is Remote Desktop Protocol. For this, we need to open the RDP inbound port. If you don't have this port open, obviously you'll not be able to RDP into the virtual machines. So let's click on this pencil icon At the moment, we are on Edit Network Interface Blade, and I'm going to leave all these defaults here. The only thing that we're going to change is public inbound ports. Let's select this checkbox, Allow Selected Ports. And remember, we want to be able to RDP into the virtual machines in our skill set. So let's drop this list down and check this checkbox, RDP 3389. So basically, with this configuration, we are opening up this port 3389 for RDP communication. And one more important thing is we have to enable public IP address. Without this, we will not be able to communicate with the virtual machines in our skill set from the internet. So let's enable this and then click OK. Finally, load balancing. If you want a load balancer to be created, check this checkbox, Use a load balancer. This is going to automatically create a load balancer and distribute the incoming traffic between all the virtual machines in our scale set. Let's leave all the defaults that we have here and then go to the scaling tab. This is where we specify the number of VMs we want in our scale set. At the moment, the instance count defaulted to 2, but we can create up to 1000 VMs. If you remember, the Azure region that we have selected, that is the East US region, has got 3 availability zones. So let's actually create 3 VMs. So each VM is placed into a separate availability zone. So even if one of the availability zones is down due to some reason, we still have the other 2 VMs available from the rest of the 2 availability zones. In case if we create 6 VMs, then each availability zone will have 2 VMs. I'm going to leave the rest of the defaults here and then review and create our skill set. Validation passed, so let's create our skill set. As you can see from the message on the screen, deployment is in progress. It's going to take a few minutes to create this virtual machine skill set. There we go. Our deployment is complete. So let's click on our resource group, RG Testing. Notice, in addition to our virtual machine skill set itself, several other resources are also created, like the NSG Network Security Group, Public IP Address, Virtual Network, Load Balancer, etc. Now, let's click on our virtual machine skill set, VMSS Demo. If you remember, we specified we want 3 VMs in our skill set. And to see those 3 VMs, click on Instances. There we go. We have all our 3 VMs up and running. Now let's say we want to log into this VM. So let's click on it and then click on this connect button. We want to connect using RDP. So let's select that. If you remember, for RDP communication, we have opened up this public port 3389. So let's click on this button, download RDP file, click on it. Provide the administrator username and password that we have specified while creating our virtual machine skill set. There we go. We are now remotely logged into our virtual machine in Azure. That's it in this video. Thank you for listening.